problem. Thank you, sir. So number two, team number two. Oh, all right, sorry.
So we'd like to start with an AV.
Can you tell which town, which part of the area?
My name is Mounika and she is Vallary. I'm from Hyderabad and she's from Delhi. We are studying in Jharkhand in BIT Mesra. We both were.
Chairs throughout the day, people who talk to themselves, who aimlessly meander the halls or stand still, waiting for a caregiver to show them where to go. Even those who walk away from the facility. It's not a healthy, vital atmosphere to absorb. Thank goodness it's not catching. But in a sense, it can be. And hanging out is not just exhibited by the residents who live in the fog of dementia. Even those who are cognizant and have mobility close themselves in their rooms until meals called. Where's the energy, I wonder? Where's the productive life? It's not in bingo or Yahtzee. These activities fill waiting time until death. Am I unique to avoid them? Do others in the ALF have longings to explore away from here? Can we not provide for residents who want to do something in and for the outside community?
Actually, starting off with the designing process, we went on a case study to a nursing home actually in Ranchi itself. There we actually heard some statements which are a bit disturbing, but then our design was developed from those statements. This says, ALC sounds depressing. I don't think an architect has much to do. Can architectural intervention give psychological cue? So these are the questions we thought that should be addressed before actually proceeding to their design. So we frame few questions like who, what, where, and how. These are the questions we need to answer in order to produce the design that is actually satisfying for both the users as well as the people who are admitting them in the ALC.
Basically, we wanted to change the opinion that people on a general mass tend to have about an ALC. When we first refer an ALC to anybody, they think it's such a depressing design. We don't want to go in it. So to change the basic opinion and how do people think about it, we wanted to change the very procedure and the base and form the basis of our concept derivation. We actually conducted a survey within our hostel, amongst the residential areas near to us, and in a nursing home, which is DAV Bariatu. From the survey report, we came to realize that the statistics of the most of the people who live in a ALC, they vary from they have an age group from 65 to 85 years old, the larger amount. And since we know our parents at present age, they have started to go into that very age group. So in order to incorporate a social and a connective quotient to the entire design, we thought, what do we want if ALC residents were our very own parents? We asked our hostel mates and batchmates. The final answers were safety as a security, that they a person tends to forget where is he staying, safety in terms of isn't he going out on the road. Is he completely surrounded by other people who might look after him, the caregivers? Then medical access. Medical access being the hospitals and the medical facilities surrounding the area in close proximity to maximum 10 kilometers so that the person may be taken to that facility in a gap of half an hour, max at half an hour. Then weather being the pleasant climate, they tend to suffer extremes and mood swings. Spiritual opportunities, when we reach this certain age, we tend to connect more to God. And that's why indulgence, to keep them deviated from the fact that they have been left over by their children to such an area, to keep them interactive with other patients and all. Interaction, accessibility, flexibility and free flow. Flexibility in terms of
design.
And when we reach that certain age, we feel that we are dependent on somebody else. And we tend to lack and feel incompetent. That's why flexibility of design, so that these people have freedom to go wherever they want. that they are independent, that they are dependent, but we want to create an environment that they feel they are independent, to provide them with their own
consideration. So our survey actually didn't end up with just the users, but then we went to the doctors actually. So what are the problems that old age or elderly face after 65 years old? So they we have divided them into certain percentages and then distributed the 30 rooms that you have suggested to give into different clusters within the design. So we have actually placed the same people who are facing the same problem in one cluster so that they could interact well, they could share their problems in a better way. So the next immediate problem we were faced upon was like with the site, actually where we are supposed to choose the site. So we have framed certain criteria for site selections.
Healthcare access, which is the major and the first most, social ecosystem, then connectivity. Connectivity in terms of these people, when they're left over in ALCs, they don't have access to any other areas. Areas being maybe I am suffering from a certain disease which has got nothing to do with my mental capabilities. I might be able to work for a certain time. So I should have connectivity to certain urban areas and certain productive places to indulge in employment options. Congestion index. Congestion index, if there's higher congestion, higher will be the pollution and higher will be the more health issues. Growth perspective in terms of for future expansion, the ongoing land crisis in India, and India being a developing country, therefore we have considered growth perspective.
Is there any chance for more ALCs in Coimbatore? That's the thing we have, that growth perspective.
Aesthetic ecosystem in terms of the climate and the surrounding species and all, land value, which is one of the most important thing.
Compared to other places, Coimbatore has less land value right now, so we thought this is also one benefiting factor for ALCs to come up.
And most importantly, there are three traditional retirement towns in India, Goa, Dehradun and Coimbatore. We chose Coimbatore due to the reasons of climate and pleasant weather issues.
And also the healthcare access.
Healthcare access. It is the second and third city in Tamil Nadu which has a good healthcare access surrounding it. Considering the climatic aspect, the major wind direction is from northeast, west and southwest. So our site orientation is basically based on the criteria to maximize the northern light, block the northern winds, incorporate the south and southwestern winds in such a way that there is cross ventilation within the interior spaces through the Venturi effect and placement of the windows. And the final, as we proceed, we'll tell you how do we have done it.
So, recently my grandmother underwent a surgery, cancer surgery. So she was undergoing a treatment. She was there in a hospital for a while, and then she is depressed all the time, even though her own family was with her. But immediately when she was brought back to the home, there is some certain recovery from her, because she kind of interacts with her friends and she will take her outside for a walk. So she feels better when she connected with the outside environment. So actually it's not the people that they that are surrounding them, but it's actually the place that's making them feel better. So we thought, why not the ALC be home itself? So why not the ALC doesn't look like an ALC but like a home?
Basically it's a home away from home. I don't have to ask my parent that I'm going to get you admitted in ALC. I'll just say you are being taken to another home. So starting from the very ghar concept, the Bhartiya ghar, and since our site is in Coimbatore, which is close to Kerala, we derived our concept from Nalluketu, the vernacular concept of Kerala. There's a central courtyard. Since the residential facilities today are designed with, there's a central corridor and four residents and blocks are arranged around it. The starting from the very basic of that, and there's this conceptivizes the primary interaction spaces. Four blocks are arranged around it, basically the four clusters, and then there's this balcony projection as we do have. These balcony projections comprehend for the connectivity and interactive spaces that we have incorporated within our plans. Moving on to the secondary interaction of spaces, when we get into our homes, we have a living room. Separate interactions, segregated interactions. Different rooms are arranged in our living rooms, and we as a family come out into the living rooms to interact with one another. So we have incorporated the living rooms again in our plan. Moving on to the tertiary interaction within the bedrooms. How do people interact with each other on a smaller area? These blocks and clusters being arranged around a central courtyard therefore justifies the Nalluketu concept and ensures the connectivity of spaces.
So, like, usually the ALCs have this corridor planning. where there is a corridor and the rooms are planked on either sides like this. So these kind of creates farther and nearer distances to different rooms. So we try to avoid them by breaking this corridor like this. We kind of created intermediate green spaces because of this breaking of clusters, because of breaking of these rooms. And then we got this intermediate greens and multiple routes to exterior environment. And again, these are there are interlinkages between each rooms. So after creating these, breaking these corridors, we created clusters, placing different clusters with green spaces in between. So we kind of achieved a compact planning, yet open and connected to the other rooms.
Basically, a person living in certain one cluster won't have to decide ki main idhar ja udhar ja. He can go to any place he wants to, depending upon the clusters that allowed. A single cluster is surrounded by number of clusters. We know that we tend to connect better to the diseases or the sufferings that we go through. So he has an option to choose where to which person he wants to get connected to and which person he wants to get socialized with.
So like this is our site plan. This is our site plan. This is our main entry, and we have provided parking for 10 cars as well as 15 two-wheeler vehicles. And then we have a service entry which leads to the staff quarters, staff residences over here. And this service entry is also connected to the ICU area for emergency purpose. Directly the ambulance can take away. We didn't provide any ambulance parking though. But the basic zoning of the site, like we said in the Naluketu concept, there's a central courtyard and we have provided our building blocks around it. This is the central courtyard and the building blocks. These are our clusters. Like these are our clusters, the rooms.
They are kept in north and northeast for natural light and to avoid heat due to south and southwest sun.
So this is the northeast of our north and northeastern part of our site, and these are the clusters. And because of these clusters, the intermediate green spaces we call them as interactive pockets,
social pockets.
So these are created, and we also have provided herbal gardens. These are the herbal gardens. The pathways between the herbal gardens are acupressure pathways. If at all they have to go and walk for a while, they walk on those acupressure pathways and all that.
We won't have to force them that you have to take this therapy for acupressure. They will be by their own, if they are walking, they will be automatically be provided with the acupressure therapy.
And the dementia patients, they usually get confused and forget the ways. So we have to provide security around our, because we have created, connected the rooms to the exterior environment. So we created earth berms surrounding the buildings, which are one is to 20 slope. So if they enter into this intermediate social pocket and they enter outside, which these intermediate social pockets are semi-covered areas, and these are completely open areas, earthworm areas. So if they enter to this area, because of the earthworm, they won't be able to go outside of the surroundings.
They won't directly land upon the surrounding road, which has vehicular access.
And one more benefit of this earthworms is like, there is road on all the sides of our site. So because of, three sides of the road, because of that, they might just go onto the road. So in order to avoid that, we have provided this. And also sound insulation, earthworms also give certain sound insulation. That can also be achieved. So
moreover, on the sustainable basis, the amount of soil that may be excavated from building construction, that will be used for the creation of earthworms surrounding the site. These spaces, since they have a maximum length of 9 meters, they can also be used for laying down of beds and lying down. Since people of this age have a tendency to go out and sleep, they put their beds outside, our grandparents. They have a tendency to sleep on terraces and all. So we didn't want to,
they can actually relax, lie down and chit-chat. And most of the ALC residents are, 75% are women. So most of the women have a tendency to gossip. So we kind of created those sort of spaces.
Our site area was 4 acres and we reached a build, FAR was 0.3. We tried to minimize our ground coverage. Covered area is more, but construction area is less. And additional areas that we suggested are for 200 square meters.
Apart from these social pockets, the rest of the roofs are flat. Like sir has questioned that. We would like to explain. We have given the flat roof for future expansion. Further in future, if there should be any expansion, we can't do that on the slope roof. So we had to provide the flat roof.
And then these interactive pockets will actually, they might get covered, but the upper floor's area will gradually reduce. So there will be constantly vertical interaction between the terraces. Moving on to the zoning plan. The private zone is faced towards the north, that is farthest away from the site to ensure the privacy. then public zone towards the entry, and as per the climatic analysis, the residential zone in north and northeastern sides, public zone and service zone, which will be occupied for lesser amount of the day, is placed towards south and southwest. Then medical consultancy in semi-private zone is in direct access to the main road for crisis and for medical access. Then the common spine, which is the congregation zone, the most of the people will be brought down to this congregation zone. These people have a tendency not to escape out of their cocoon and they keep themselves into their room. So our entire plan focuses basically on how to force them through the design to actually come into the central congregation space. So clusters are arranged in such a manner that they are forced and they have to come out to the central area. Then there are intermediate open spaces for interaction, again gossiping and chit-chatting. The placement of the individual clusters lets us also prescribe a fire escape route. If in condition of fire or any hazards, they don't have a vigor to move, and if the distances are really far away, there are obviously chances of casualties. So fire cell concept basically allows them to escape out through the intermediate spaces that are created through the earth berms and surroundings. Since the ratio is 1:20, there won't be a problem. And for physically this handicap, we'll tell the escape route and plan.
So basically these are different division of the rooms, the 30 rooms. It was specified that we are supposed to give 10 rooms for physically handicapped, so 10 rooms were given for them, and rest of the rooms we have divided based on our survey. This is the dementia. As soon as they enter outside in the corridor, they see only single pathway. Like if we have provided dementia over here, they see two to three pathways. They get confused because of those pathways. So when they enter out of this room, they see only single pathway, and from here the caregivers will take care of them. And this is the psychic, basically. We have kind of bit isolated them. So they have this, okay, sorry. And then further, the caretakers' rooms are provided in such a way that surveillance is possible over every part of the central congregation space. And the rooms were placed such that they are at a distance of 30 to 40 meters, because that is a comfortable distance for physically handicapped.
And even the fire escape distances as per NBC are 30 meters. So we tried to relate it that.
And we have dedicated living areas. Unless we enter into the kitchen of our home, we don't feel that it's our home. So we kind of created small kitchenette. If they are able to prepare anything, they can prepare them that for themselves. And we have a attached living room so that they can sit there and in the intermediate clusters itself.
As in the clip we saw that the person said that there are prescribed meal times that they have to eat at that given time only. They have to go to the community place. So in order to break that thing, in the living areas there is pantry. Food can be brought down from the central kitchen to that pantry, and whenever the person wishes to eat, he can go there. And on his free time, obviously he can cook, and she or he can cook and feed others.
And this is the room detail. The room size was based such that the wheelchair could circulate properly within the room at 1.5 meter radius. Not only here, even the corridors everywhere, there are 2.5 meters corridors so that wheelchairs can move clear. And the most important concept of our design is reviving senses, actually. So as soon as we tend to lose one sense, our other senses get elevated. So we try to use their deficiencies to make their benefits. Mm-hmm. So when they have sight impairment, when they actually could see better, we have when the patients are immobile and inside the room itself, we have provided windows in such a way that they could see into the outside environment. They can see, observe the changing environment, trees, raining and all that, so they could better connect. And the sound, we have provided fountains in the central area so that the sound could lead them into the central area. And the smell, these intermediate pockets, they have certain different plantations at different area, like jasmine rose. We can differentiate smell, right? So we sort of created those spaces so they could follow the smell. And same is the touch. They have tendency to walk while
gripping on different things.
So we have provided different sort of textures wall at different areas so they could identify the area even though they lose certain.
Basically, we have converted their disabilities into their very essence of the design. How a blind or a person with vision impairment can also walk around and feel independent instead of being dependent upon the caregivers at all times.
So we have provided a healthcare club apart from the programs that brief has been decided upon. And then that is Ayurvedic treatment. Like as we said, the Coimbatore is very nearby to Kerala. We have provided three types of treatment, wet therapy, aromatherapy, and sun therapy. They don't need certain techniques or technicians for that. It's a very simple process. The wet treatment is for constipation. Most of the elderly face constipation problems. So we thought that could be a benefit. Even I face constipation, so that would help. So, and aromatherapy is for stress. So stress, that can be done. And sun therapy, that can be done in the early morning. Basically, this health club is on the eastern part, northeastern part. So in the morning, sun can be good for them, for vitamin D and all that. We also provided a yoga and meditation center, which is derived on the concept of
joining hands, so that they are able to connect on the spiritual basis, creating spiritual opportunities.
And then amphitheater. So we were a little confused about amphitheater because it has stairs, so whether they would be. So we kind of provided proper access through ramps and all, only two stairs. So basically this place is for performing their own talents. They have tendency to sit in the evening times and sing and say poetries and all that, so they could do that. Even the this site is surrounded by educational institutions. They can come and join the ALC residents, so that things can be possible.
It provides them basically with a platform to exhibit their talents. If one of them eventually goes out, the others will get motivated, and obviously there will be a cycle of positivity.
So these are, Vallary, can you highlight the things? These are the design features that we have done.
Basically, the slanting walls that we were discussing earlier, they are provided with perforations and jali walls. In South India, there is a concept of making rangoli each and every morning outside the house. So when the eastern sun falls on these walls, obviously, naturally rangolis will be created on the ground. So, and
that's the shade and shadow effect.
They will have a homely effect in the environment, and they will feel that they aren't living in their homes, and they have incapabilities of making a rangoli on sitting down. So
that's there.
Then giving power to them. Giving power to them, basically, they have smaller gardens. They can grow for plantations and all, and they don't have to depend upon others.
They don't have to actually move to herbal gardens for gardening, and they can have small plantations, take care of one small plant if possible. Otherwise, the administration will take care of that. So if there is a plant over, they feel independent among them. So that freedom should be there. That's what we thought.
Then freedom to view basically is for palliative patients, so that each and everyone has a clear access to the outside environment from the window, keeping the cell level in context. Then freedom to interaction through the intermediate pockets and the terraces that we have created. Accident prevention is through the jute mats that we have provided in order to prevent the entrance of the rain into the corridor spaces. These jute mats can be handled manually, and there's no energy used into these.
So these are the views that we have captured. These are the shade and shadow effects. We can see shade and shadow. These are the intermediate semi-covered pergolas and all that.
And then flat roofs is for future expansion.
So let's...
there's one thing I would like to add, we forgot. The colors that we have actually put is for moods, to add vigor to these people because they feel really depressed. The orange and yellows that we have played with. Thank you.
So, yeah, you are always the first one.
Very impressive. You have almost touched every chord, even the emotional chords, by sort of connecting your parents. That's how you do, because it's very emotional. You know, it's emotionally attached to these spaces, and rightfully you have been able to connect these things. And you have thought many things out of the box.
Thank you.
You have thought of the haptic senses, what people have to look at. You talked about the smell, the touch, and so many other feelings, where people who are faced with dementia tend to lose out on these features, and architects are to see to that how they can kindle that interest or that feeling onto them. Okay, one thing which you could have worked out on. See, you have these wind chimes. You heard of these wind chimes?
Yes, sir. Yes.
These small, empty pipes, which clang on to each other and create sound.
Yes. Okay.
Could also be a mode of creating a very harmonious, very interesting sound. As the wind flows, it tends to sort of create that melancholy of sound. It's a natural process, which could be integrated onto that. And the other thing what I feel was, you on the terraces, you have these places where you can have gossip. You know, what happens only for women you're talking about? What is that activity you have generated for men?
So basically, my grandfather had a habit of sleeping outside on bed.
Okay.
So with that,
so
we have created
amphitheater. Mostly men do that. So amphitheater. Do they sing, they say poetry, they say experiences.
Yeah,
so
play with cards and all.
Okay. And the aspect of on the terraces, whatever process of grab bars or whatever it is, we need to have some sort of a security so that they don't fall off.
So actually, that is for future expansion. We have covered it in our sheets. The entire process of blocking up masses, vertical interaction.
Okay. What I mean to say, you had this gossiping places, right?
Yes.
So you have the terrace, and you have not shown any section where you have some sort of a protection. And little bit of more in-depth sections can be. But on the whole, it's very good, very interesting, very thought-provoking, and I can go on.
Thank you.
The positives.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I'll just repeat the same comments. I've done a dementia care center in UK, and you have really, really ticked all the boxes. Really ticked all the boxes. The only thing which I just want to kind of mention, you mentioned about the herbal gardens towards the periphery. Instead of herbal gardens, what you can think of, because it's to do with the memory loss and how the memory loss can be given back to them, it's something called as sensory gardens. That you create some sensory spaces or some sensory objects for them to come and look and feel and touch them, so that they can go back in their past and try to retaliate and bring back their memories back again.
Okay.
That's one of the key things which you have just a small bit which I think was just missed out. That's fun. And the second thing which I just want to talk about is, I don't know, we didn't mention anywhere about the flooring pattern or anything else.
We have used compliant flooring, C-O-M-P-L-I-A-N-T. I don't know the pronunciation.
Compliant, yeah.
It is basically for injury prevention. Sponge sheet that's laid down beneath that flooring, a rubber flooring basically, so that when a person falls, the amount of injury caused is comparatively less.
Also to do with the palliative care, they are more sort of patients who are nearing their death.
Yes.
So
yes.
How are you going to bring them back from that depression? I didn't see anything of that sort of in the design. I know you're bringing the sunlight, those rangolis and all that, but that's to kind of enhance in the morning and the evening or afternoon, whatever. But to bring in some life in the design, there's still have been tiny bit of palliative care.
So we have given actually a special type of windows.
Window design basically.
It has, even if the person is sleeping, standing, or even he's sitting on a wheelchair, he can get a proper see-through through to the nature, and also that is provided.
So over here, this one, the right ones. There's this ratio of x by y, which is to be maintained between 1.2 to 1.5 for the clear view of the person who is lying on the bed.
So we kind of created that, but not in specifically.
I'm an architect, practicing architect, and I see. First of all, I congratulate both of you for so much of work, so much of research, and holistic approach that you could touch upon. Just to improvise further, I would say, the next stage would be thinking about signages. See, you said that straight corridors will create an impression of being far, but if you want to do something else, you are tend to get lost. As a young person also, you tend to get lost, where older person will definitely be lost. So next layer would be, next layer of understanding within the same project, brilliant work, lot of efforts and lot of thinking, which is definitely required. That's the next stage. It's a couple of more things, but we can allow them to do this. Brilliant work, congrats.
Could you complete this in Valentine?
Sir, we are actually fifth year students, and we have a thesis going on.
Yeah, so because I'm presuming that you are always short of time.
So if you have extended this competition deadline, we would be still be working. Like,
I know.
It was better for us that you didn't extend much.
I can see that. And second question is that, where is your office? When are you going to start your office? Because I can feel that a lot of people are going to come to you to get. Yeah. And okay, now to the missing points. Again, the people who are going to deal, who are going to work in this area, those have been left out. So there's nothing has been talked about them, and the services have not been.
Administration is there, sir. Can I just show my sheets, presentation sheets? It's there in the folder only.
It's fine.
It's okay.
First of all, what's your name?
Vallary.
Nandini?
Vallary.
Nandini and?
Mounika.
Amazing work, girls. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
I also wanted to add those 2 points, palliative care and signage. Obviously, that is next level of doing it. For palliative care, you can also visit Karuna Shrey in Bangalore. It's very nicely designed. And I don't know about who is going to win the competition, but I want to offer you three things. First, I'm inviting you to Chandigarh. Be my guest there. I would want you to have a presentation in Chandigarh College of Architecture, official presentation. So that is first thing. Second thing, be my guest. So Chandigarh has lot to teach in terms of architecture, and I'll personally take you along to all the different places. And third, I would want to work with you guys on this project to make it sure that it actually comes on ground.
Thank you.
So after the presentation, talk to me. I'll take your number, you take my card, and we are definitely talking after this, right?
Thank you.
Amazing work done. Thank you.
Are you like crying or you're happy crying?
No, I'm happy.
Happy crying. Even if she's worried, she cries. Actually, she laughs when we were like, there is this deadline and we have to submit it, and she's working in the last minute also. She's doing this detailing. And I said, stop it, we have to submit. She's like laughing and she's working. Thank you so much for your comments.
Exactly.
Everyone,
thank
really,
so
really,
much.
It really means thank you.
Yeah, hi. Fantastic job, really. Everybody is expressing the same sentiments. Very good. Indeed, you have created a happy place. I quite was impressed with the rangoli bit, sunlight falling through and the people feeling just at home. Okay, chhat pe kaise chadenge?
Ma'am, actually,
where are the staircases? I haven't seen one.
Presentation.
You need to think.
Okay.
Bring them in.
Let's move required to put up.
Yes. Sure. But beautiful job.
Thank you.
I just want to highlight one point. It's actually it's well arranged, representation wise it's so good. As an architect, I can praise you. it's perfect. One thing that, you know, I don't see in your site plan, I don't see any, you know, gathering space in case of fire. There's no space to, you know, put those people in. Okay. Right, so yeah, you can say assembly point. Yeah, it's a perfect term for that. So I want to see that also, if you can, you know, take it further. For yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So I think, you know, you brought me very close to my mother. She's now 84 years of age and she needs many of these things which you mentioned. We, you know, I think we'll work on that. I'll work on it, you know. Many of things I have done it actually, unconsciously. But I think that's the way to put it is really, really good. The way you have described it, the sales pitch was class.
Thank
good
you.
Luck.
Thank you, sir.
And like what ma'am said, you know, you're most welcome to visit us in Mumbai anytime.
Thank you, sir.
This is the second time you have come, right?
Yes, sir.